I don't know nothing about whatever other little groups y'all talking about. But you listen to The Vicky Show. You listening to The Vicky Show. You listen to what I'm saying. That's what you're listening to today. Be seated. Listen. Okay, Instagram, I'm getting ready to use this device. Come on over to Fly Nubian Queen on YouTube. But the moment white people start to put a demand on you, they tell you to jump. You don't just jump. You go so far as to say, how high? Now, let me show you this picture again of the Shark Tank's Damon, not Raymond, Damon John. What happened, Vicky? Well, apparently, by the way, family, did you all know that I think he was one of the co-creators of FUBU? How many of you all remember that apparel line, FUBU, for us, by us? That's him. And I think he's been on Shark Tank over a decade. Is it 11 years? I think I read somewhere, if I'm not mistaken. This is the fellow that we're talking about, family. He just did a Nick Cannon 2.0. This is the fellow we're referring to. That's him. Are y'all hearing me today? Blessed and empowered by Minister Farrakhan's beautiful address yesterday, as was the rest of the world, especially in Black society. Watch this. Watch this. This is the tweet. I still keep getting messages from people having a hard time finding us, family. Again, I don't control being shadow banned, which means that the different platforms can sometimes make it difficult for folks to find us. And I don't control the fact that they didn't send out the alerts today. So I apologize for those of you that are having a hard time. Just keep liking, sharing, family. Thumbs up, share, share, share. Now watch this. Look at the tweet, because I want you to see the receipts for yourself. Look very closely at the tweet that Damon John, after listening to Minister Farrakhan's beautiful address at DMX's memorial. Y'all see this? I'm going to read it, but just look for now, because I want you to know I'm not making anything up. Okay, watch this. For the DMX funeral, his deep understanding of the Bible and respect for other people's religions was truly inspiring. Hashtag rip DMX. Do y'all hear that? Okay. Watch this. That's lovely, right? That's beautiful. He says, what a powerful speech from Minister Louis Farrakhan for the DMX funeral. His deep understanding of the Bible and respect for other people's religions was truly inspiring. That's the tweet he put out, family. Are y'all hearing me? That's the tweet he put out. After them people, y'all better don't play with me today. And family, I want you all to be careful of the comments, because you all know that some of these platforms unfairly and unnecessarily censor us. So we want to go overboard. We're people of excellence. We cross our T's, we dot our I's. We can still make our point and be honest, but being careful with the language that we use in the comment section, okay? There are different rules on the different platforms that I'm on, so I always have to be mindful of that. Are y'all hearing me today? Thank you so much. Watch this. So he gave this beautiful tweet about how inspiring Minister Farrakhan's words were and how respectful his words were. And y'all, not even hardly a few minutes later, we didn't even get 24 hours. We didn't even get 12 hours. Y'all play too much. We didn't even get 8 hours later. Y'all better listen. He started to get backlash from white people. Y'all play too much. Damon John, allegedly the shark, started to get backlash from white people who did not like that a black man was complimenting and praising another black man that white people don't like. Y'all play too much. It only took a few minutes, family. And this black looking male, with the quickness, turned his behind over, bent down and squatted deep. He spread them wide. You high paid slaves who's clearly pressed to keep your proximity to whiteness. Thumbs up, share, share, share. He said, in regards to my tweet regarding DMX's funeral, my comments on Minister Farrakhan were only related to what I just witnessed tonight, unbeknownst to his prior stances. As someone who was fortunate enough to have a stepdad of the Jewish faith, I do not condone and never would condone any anti-Semitic prejudice or any remarks of hatred. The prior tweet will be removed to avoid further pain and confusion to anyone who has felt hurt in the past by any negative comments of his. You disgust me, Damon. Damon, you are a disgusting, reprehensible fraud of a black man. Isn't it something, family? Number one, first and foremost, as one of my brothers was discussing with me, Damon John's words are disrespectful, first of all, to DMX. Your words are disrespectful because it was the wishes of his family that knew his heart for Minister Farrakhan, that knew his love for Minister Farrakhan, that decided to have him as a guest to speak in the first place. How dare you? You little disgusting bussy who is so clearly pressed to maintain your proximity to whiteness. You are a high paid multi-million dollar slave. Those who hate masculine black men who exposed white supremacy and who push for the elevation and the liberation and the empowerment of black people, they are enemy number one in this war. Y'all ain't hearing me. I said masculine black men who expose our open enemy, who empower black people, who expose the agenda of white supremacy to destroy us, who's uncompromising. They are enemy number one to our open enemy. So Minister Farrakhan, I think the address might have been maybe 18 to 20 minutes, right? He gave such a beautiful, beautiful address. I want you to listen to one of Lear Cohen's colleagues.
While Edgar Bronfman Jr. was meeting with Suge Knight in the back of a limousine in Santa Monica, after which Edgar Bronfman Jr. invested $200 million in Interscope for Death Row Records. While Edgar Bronfman Jr. was in this meeting with Suge Knight, Edgar Bronfman Sr. was meeting with the Honorable Brother Minister Farrakhan. Edgar Bronfman Sr. And listen to what Edgar Bronfman Sr. said to the Honorable Brother Minister Farrakhan in 1996. He said these words to a beloved minister.
You're going to listen to Minister Farrakhan speak it himself. The Bronfmans that you're hearing about now are the same types of people that Lear Cohen is. These are the same colleagues and the culture vultures that use music, that weaponize hip hop, that weaponize music to undo black people. While he was sitting there telling you how one of them, the son, was meeting with Suge Knight in a limousine, the older one was meeting with the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan some time ago. Some of you all don't even know that these kinds of things are happening. And I'm just trying to let you know, these are the circles and these are similar schemes that Lear Cohen is engaged in. I'm getting ready to let you listen to another clip in a second, but just indulge me for just a couple of minutes here, okay? This is very brief. Y'all know I give nothing but receipts. I want you to listen. Thumbs up, thumbs up. Thumbs up, thumbs up, thumbs up.
If I share this story with you. His name was Mr. Edgar Bronfman. Billionaire. Shenley Company. Was it Shenley? Seagram's. See, I know you all know.
Did you all hear that? Seagram's. I see some of y'all putting a name in there. Y'all remember. Somebody just said, educators, because you know I'm going to do it. I've talked about it before. Some of you new people don't know how to roll. Y'all think I'm just being funny and slamming a gavel and talking crazy. Y'all just keep listening. Thumbs up, share, share, share.
I was in his penthouse. It was arranged by Mike Wallace and Rock Newman. My wife was with me, my son and others. And when he came in the room, we shook hands. And he said, not Minister Farrakhan, Lewis. See, white folks talk to you like that. See, they all feel that they own us. And you never grow up big enough for them to call you mister. See, but they're dealing with a different black man today. I will not allow you to disrespect me, even if I'm in your house. I'll whoop your behind in your own house. Why? If you invite me into your house, then you ought to respect me as a guest in your house and not call me on a first name basis when you don't know me at all.
Now let's stop right there and put my little hashtag in. What's my little hashtag, family? Somebody put hashtag black people don't do that. If you're going around here calling your mom and your daddy by your first name, you better shift and you better recognize, baby, honey, there's a new standard. Somebody say black people don't do that. I'm telling you this because the Seagram family, Seagram's, that company, the son that was meeting with Suge Knight in the car in the limousine, the older one was meeting with the Honorable Minister Louis Farrakhan while some of y'all was bopping y'all head to some of that music that was telling you to kill yourself, take drugs, kill your brother. You didn't know that behind the scenes they knew what they was doing, which was why they was meeting with Minister Farrakhan. Somebody talk black to me. The Bronfmans, yeah, Seagram is the company. Y'all didn't know that the younger Bronfman was working on the hip-hop artists like Suge Knight. And the older ones was trying to meet with Minister Farrakhan. Y'all better slam that thumbs up button. Share, 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 share. I'm letting you know and I'm letting you hear directly from his own mouth. So when you see Minister Farrakhan talking on yesterday about a DMX hip hop legend, and then you see the likes of a Lear Cohen, who's a culture vulture, who wants to make war with black folk, and you don't even know what's going on, y'all sitting up here, you bowing the knee, Damon, John, and ain't nobody sitting here talking about the demon and devil Lear Cohen. Why was he there? Why aren't you guys offended by these kinds of individuals? I'm getting ready to let you listen to Leah Cohen for yourself in about 2 minutes. Listen to this last clip from Minister Farrakhan. I'm trying to let you all know the behind the scenes of those that's weaponizing hip hop. Stuff that you don't even know, but you just running your mouth to myself. Don't nobody care about that old man no more. But they're meeting with them in secret, fool. The Brothmans, yes. Listen. Remember, Mr. Farrakhan is talking about the old school, the father Brothman that met with him. Listen to what he said.
I'm not your companion.
Lewis, would you like a drink? I said, oh, no, sir, Mr. Bronfman. See, I'm respecting him. No, sir, Edgar. I didn't do that. See, when somebody else shows ignorance, you don't get down in the stupid box with them. You rise intelligently. I said, no, sir, Mr. Bronfman, I don't drink. He said, well, do you drink orange juice? I said, yes. He said, that's me.
Listen.
Okay. He said, do you listen to music? I said, yes, of course. He said, that's me.
This is what old white people who run and stuff behind the scenes are sitting there telling black masculine men who they see are a threat for black society. Not for black Muslims, but for black people in general.
Do you go to the movies? I said, occasionally. He said, that's me.
Did y'all hear that? So this man is bragging about him with his drinking. Alcohol, orange juice, movies. Y'all listen.
I said, oh, Mr. Bronfman, I know you're rich and a powerful man. I said, but when the God I serve get ready for you, see, none of your riches can keep you here 1 second beyond the time. So who is really powerful? See, most of you Negroes, and I got to say it, because many of us are like little whores. I got to speak straight words. I ain't got a lot of time with you. And I'm not going to pussyfoot around with truth when I know you're whoring. I don't give a damn who got money. Edgar Senior.
Watch this.
The co-founder of the mega group and patriarch of the family that is the epicenter of the new establishment Illuminati.
Now I'm going to stop right there. The description under this beautiful piece by the great Dr. Weston Muhammad, by the way, it's called There's Some Whores in This House. You can pull it up on YouTube by Dr. Weston Muhammad. There's Some Whores in This House. Watch this. Understanding WAPP, y'all know that means wet, A-P-U-S-S. That was the Megan Stallion or Cardi B mess. Suki with the good coochie. They did all that. That WAPP. Understanding WAPP and the weaponization of hip hop. He says how a major aim of weaponized hip hop today, as yesterday, is to replace the idea of a virtuous black girl and woman with that of a ratchet black girl and woman. He says in 1991, like I told you, I'm paraphrasing some of this. He said in 91, music exec Leah Cohen gave us the female rap group. Did you all know this? Leah Cohen. Why am I bringing up Leah Cohen? Leah Cohen is the one that brought a message for DMX, the white man who didn't show his face. It was his voice you heard after Minister Farrakhan. Why is everybody mad about Minister Farrakhan? But nobody is upset that Leah Cohen had nothing to say. Well, Vicky, what about Leah Cohen? Give us some more information on Leah Cohen. Watch this. Leah Cohen can't gave us the female rap group Bitches with Problems, who were marketed as the female version of the raunchy and pornographic male group Two Live Crew. Their album title was The Bitches. Did y'all know that that was an album title? Leah Cohen said, y'all better listen, this white man whose voice you heard but face you didn't see, that came on right after Minister Farrakhan, listen. Leah Cohen said that the raunchy bitches were a more authentic representation of urban black girls than the positivity of Queen Latifah. There are a lot more, that's a quote. There are a lot more, that's a quote. There are a lot more, that's a quote, black bitches than black queens, Cohen would have us believe. Why wasn't everybody upset that Leah Cohen, the one who gave us Bitches with Problems female rap group, they were marketed as a female version of the raunchy and pornographic male group Two Live Crew. Why wasn't anybody mad about that? Why isn't anybody mad about the fact that this disgusting devil Leah Cohen said that the raunchy bitches were a more authentic representation of urban black girls than a queen? Don't play with me! I'm trying to give you some more insight about the why the powers that about why the powers that shouldn't be can't stand Minister Farrakhan. While y'all sitting there running your mouths, you got the Brothmans meeting with Minister Farrakhan. Slowness, listen. This racist president of Columbia Records, Don Lenner, L-E-N-N-E-R, thought that Bitches was funny and, quote, totally supported the project, but disallowed Columbia's brand to be associated with it. Today, Megan Thee Stallion, this was a few months ago when Dr. Wesley put this as his description. Today, Megan Thee Stallion is a Leah Cohen artist. She was the first lady, quote, of his label 300. And City Girls is Coach K's artist. Coach K said Leah Cohen is his mentor. Cardi B is Craig Kalman, K-A-L-L-M-A-N, and Julie Greenwald's artist. These two proteges of Leah Cohen. Dr. Wesley gives us heavy receipts and insights, and I fact-checked some of his receipts some time back, and I read you guys directly from an old article. I believe it was from the LA Times. Don't quote me on it. But I read you. I pulled the receipt on that one. It was too much for me to give you today to relitigate all of that, so just got to look at some of my past shows I did. That's how heavy I bring it to you. But instead, I wanted to give y'all something, because some of this is too heavy for some of y'all. Let me keep it simple, because some of y'all like the Breakfast Club. You want me to keep it simple. Okay, this, what you're about to hear, is a simple 1 minute and few second clip. Leah Cohen, this white culture vulture that pushed death, murder, and drugs through music. He's been interviewed on the Breakfast Club some time back.
Really rock.
And said this. I think it was about 2 years ago, because I've discussed this too on the Breakfast Club.
Particularly on women, really rough, particularly on women. But I think it helped change the course of the crack epidemic. I don't know what's this opioid thing, man.
Being what? A crackhead wasn't cool. Now it seems like they're making it cool to be drinking lean and syrup. And
it's the most dangerous. It's the most dangerous thing that's facing our society.
So why sign an artist that would promote that?
Because I already answered that question. You weren't paying attention. She asked me talent or issues, and I said talent. But I have to. I can't give up on people.
I'm saying that's hypocritical, though.
You're saying it's opportunistic. Yeah. I got people to feed.
He said it's opportunistic, him pushing lean, him pushing drugs with his artists. He said, but he got people to feed. Somebody just asked, Vicky, what's the point of this? Let me help you. Sit down in the back of the class. I'm going to try to say this and hope that you're not a troll or that you're being unintelligent on purpose. I'm having mercy on some of your people. The point of me bringing this up, Slowness, is that the world would have you to believe that Minister Farrakhan is somebody to hate. They said they had a problem with Minister Farrakhan speaking, a man who's done nothing but love on black people for 60-some years. But the man who's a culture vulture, who puts his death and destruction, who spoke at DMX's funeral, nobody's got nothing to say. You offended about a black man who's done nothing but love and serve black people for 60-some years, but you will let a white man who does nothing but destroy black people off the hook. That's the point of this. I was giving you snippets of other people similar to the Lee or Cohens of the world who run and weaponize hip-hop, music, television. They control much of the society. I always teach some things are taught, some things are caught. I'm gonna say that again. Some things are caught, some things are taught. There are some things that are taught in a traditional way, but there are some things that you are taught through experience, circumstance, situation, and other means. Sometimes the best thing to do is to listen and re-listen. Sometimes the best thing to do is after my show is over, you listen to the whole thing again. I know it's heavy for some of you all to listen because thinking is new for some people. That's going to be a t-shirt. Vicky Dillard fan page, y'all remind me to make that as one of the goals down the road. Somebody just said 3,000 people is not enough to listen to this. That's right, beloved. Make sure you like, share, and subscribe. But I'm thankful for those of you that are here. The quality individuals that's watching this, it's up to you to take what you hear and you spread it on social media. You teach it to your babies and children. You teach it to those that are within your circle. I'm happy about our growth and we're going to continue to grow. But I was giving you insight to let you know the thinking. Listen, and I had to give you a relevant little show that's got a platform that's called The Breakfast Club. They brought him on and you're listening directly from him. This is the same white man that y'all heard yesterday. That's the Lear Cohen, the man that's talking on the Breakfast Club. He's the one that spoke after Minister Farrakhan and didn't show his face. Nobody is upset about this killer through music of black people. But you got a problem with a black man that's done nothing but love on. You better go sit your funny looking self down. Listen again.
I'm saying that's hypocritical though.
It's opportunistic. I got people to feed. I got a business to run.
You're gonna make Dame.
This white man said, pushing lean and drugs through his music and artists. He said it's opportunistic. Y'all listen. He said it's opportunistic. He said he got people to feed. He said he's got a business to run. How many of y'all gonna start believing finally that business is warfare?
Take this clip and call you a culture vulture.
I got a business to run.
You're gonna make Dame Dash take this clip and call you a culture vulture.
Who's Dame Dash? You brought him up. I don't even know him. I don't even know him. So you bring him his name up. I don't even know him. So
y'all made a lot of money together.
Made a lot of
money. Come on, Leo. Don't do that to him.
I don't know him. I really don't. So,
he made a lot of money with Dame Dash. Y'all remember Dame Dash kind of called him out sometime back. Now this white man sitting up there playing dumb, talking about he don't know who this black man is, who he know was a doggone mover and shaker in the music industry. I'm trying to get you all to see. We have no respect for Damon John. That little shark, that little guppy. We don't have no respect for you, traitor. The only person you should have had a problem with was this fellow right here who spoke at DMX's funeral, who didn't show his face. And who knows what negative impact and influence he may have had in DMX's life that we don't even know about. Because he's already told us what he's about. And I gave y'all a whole lot of other receipts enough information for you to go research yourself.